gathered here to attend this international conference on dialogue for SDG, where international dialogue with the interreligious and we will support the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals for Inclusive Society. Here I would like to discuss, if anyone would like to take note for today's and tomorrow's session, please raise your hand so our colleague will definitely help you with a notepad. One more announcement. For tomorrow and today's plenary session, especially for tomorrow, if anyone would like to register for their interesting panel, please register outside desk. It is my immense pleasure to introduce KAISI's Secretary General, His Excellency Faisal Bin Lomber. I really like to invite him for the talk. Thank you so much. Please, sir.
So many people can catch up because I think the traffic today is amazing, you know, just to reach this location. But when I came in, I saw you, right? It's really a celebration. It's a celebration. After 5 years, we see all of you coming here to Vienna to celebrate with us the success of this program. And what's good about it, it's not only a graduation or a training. We decided to go deeper. I mean, discussion around the SDGs and the SDGs goals, well, welcome, we Ambassador Indian, welcome to. I was going to wait a little bit until also the Saudi delegation from the embassy to arrive, so I can thank all of them. Now, Dr. Samak, please come here. No way, you are a board member. Maybe you can promote me after this. I need a promotion. Tell Dr. Muhammad. That's it. Next to over. No, it's really good, you know. I'm slowing down so you can catch up with everything. Anyway, it's a pleasure and honor for me to welcome all of you and to thank you for your participation. I would like to thank the COP members, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, the Republic of Austria, the Kingdom of Spain, and the Holy See as a founding observer. Also today, we decided to invite our board members. Chief Rabbi David Rosen decided to come, and we are with, I think he will be around. He's represented by his wife. Thank you. And Dr. Muhammad Samak, who taught me how to know more about the interfaith business. And Dr. Hamad Al-Majid. And also we're supposed to have Metropolitan Emmanuel with us. Unfortunately, he's a little bit, you know, he feels that he will, he needs a little rest, you know, he didn't feel good, but he will be okay. So we are grateful to all of you and to engage in sustainable development goals. That's really a big thing. And that's in the heart of what KAISI is doing. Most of our programs, most of our initiatives now is directed to save the sustainable development goals, which is really very important for all of us. I don't know how much you know about KC, but I'm sure that you visited our site, and I'm sure that you will not accept our invitation without checking what who we are. We are an IGO. We are maybe the only intergovernmental institutions in the world who set an interreligious dialogue. So it is natural for us to engage in exploring the discussion around the SDGs, especially SDG 4, 5, 16, and 17. In the beginning, when we start, if you tell anybody, maybe especially the policymaker, to seek the advice or to consult with religious leaders, they will tell you, no, stay away from them. Now, we are seeing a growing interest in bringing religious leaders to the dialogue table so they can help support policymakers. That's very important for us. And in the beginning, it was very difficult. When I started 2005, serving this initiative, it took us 7 years to convince decision makers, especially in the West, to trust the religious leaders' advice or wisdom. But now we can see that United Nations and other international institutions, I will not say calling religious leaders to help them, but also say so that's really for us, it's a good news that wherever we go, they will tell us that we brought something good for the humanity. In a recent article defending the United Nations by senior religious leaders, among them some of our board members, the authors underline the similarities between the goals of religious leaders and the principles of the founding charter of the United Nations. They wrote, our faiths call upon us in different ways to practice tolerance and live together in peace with one another as good neighbors, and to unite our strength to maintain international peace and security. The very same words of the UN Charter. Precisely because we are faith leaders from all faiths, from different corners of the world, with the longest legacy of serving communities, we can say with total conviction that our world needs a United Nations. Our conference team and the principle behind KC Fellow Program rest on the belief that dialogue, in particular interreligious dialogue, find its deepest relevance in the light of sage or human development. So this shows you how much and why we are doing this program. And I can say that now, after 5 years developing this unique program and having almost 93 fellows in this this room. And tomorrow we will celebrate handing the certificate to maybe number 279. That's really good. That means we have almost an ambassador for IRD in every corner of the world, which is really, for us, is an added value and a treasure. We know when you decided to come and join this program, well, it's not a promotion like me, looking for a promotion, or running after an official position, but you are coming because you deeply believe in serving your community. And you want to learn from the others, whether they are from the same religion or from different religion. We are all a human being. So in this regard, I don't want to take too much because Dr. Oberlin started giving me some signals. And he's warning me to listen to him. I am grateful to all of you. And I am grateful also to our friend Christine Evans from the USA. Thank you for accepting our invitation to be the keynote speakers today. It's really important for us to listen to you and to listen to your experience. I'm sure that through your service, you went through so many of these activities, and you know what does it mean to have like these people who are going to listen to you, so they can learn the best ways of serving sustainable development goals. And this is really very important for us. Thank you again. I wish you all success in this evening and tomorrow in the conference. Thank you very much.